Hello guys, welcome back to GK Code Labs. Some of you guys have requested to see a demo on how we can schedule big data jobs in Oozie or Shell scripting. So in this video, I'll give you a brief idea on what Oozie is and what is its use in big data projects. Very briefly, we'll discuss on this. Then I'll also give you a hands-on demo on how you can submit and schedule a big data job with help of Oozie UI. After that, I'll also show and explain how you can do same with shell scripting. First, let's see what is Oozie. So Oozie is an orchestration system for Hadoop jobs. As you know, in big data world, there are not fixed number of tools that we use. There are a variety of tools for different tasks. Like we might use scope jobs for data ingestion, some MapReduce jobs, some Spark jobs, or maybe some Hive scripts, Pig scripts. So there are a variety of different kind of jobs that we use in our complete big data pipeline. And all those different jobs need to be in some order and also automated so that all the different tasks in that pipeline are done at the required time. Oozie is designed to run multi-stage Hadoop jobs as a single job that we can call an Oozie job. So we can link our different jobs, suppose Pig scripts, Hive scripts, MapReduce jobs, or Spark jobs, and we can maintain an order that which goes first and which goes after that if they have interdependencies, and create one single Oozie job. And that Oozie job can be scheduled to whatever time we want. So there are few key terms that you should know before starting with Oozie. That is workflow jobs. So workflows are, as I told you, they contain our order and flow of all the jobs that are to be scheduled in one Oozie job. So workflow jobs are run on demand. Then comes our coordinator jobs. The Oozie jobs that are run periodically, suppose we have scheduled it. Let's say an example, we have scheduled it every day at 12 a.m., every day at 2 p.m. So those jobs which run periodically, that are called coordinator jobs. Then comes the bundle jobs. It is a collection of multiple coordinator jobs managed as a single job. So one bundle job, if it is scheduled, it might run more than one coordinator jobs. So this was just the basic idea. And before we start scheduling the jobs, there are two major files that you need to develop when you want to schedule an Oozie job. These two files are workflow.xml and job.properties. The workflow.xml contains the flow and order of the jobs, what all scripts and jobs we are scheduling in that particular Oozie job. And the job.properties has the properties and arguments that are required by the scripts and jobs inside that Oozie job. So there are two approaches that we can follow while scheduling an Oozie job: the UI-based approach and the custom approach. In custom approach, we have to create the workflow.xml and job.properties according to our needs, whatever components we need. We have to define it in form of an XML and provide the other arguments related to job in job.properties. So this is completely custom. Also in real life projects, the manual approach is more preferred. The second approach is UI based. Cloudera U provides us very good interface where we can schedule our workflows, where we can submit our workflows, defining all the jobs and create coordinators to schedule them. In this first session of Oozie, I'll explain the UI based approach, and in the upcoming tutorials, I'll explain the manual approach. So let's go to our Cloudera VM and get started with Oozie job scheduling. So in this tutorial, I'm considering a simple word count jar file that I'll show you how it will work if we run manually, and then we will try to schedule the same with Oozie. So this is my jar file. It basically takes two arguments, the input directory and the output directory. It reads all the files from the input directory, counts the words, and generates the output in the output directory. So let me show you what input we are giving to this jar, and then we will see if it is generating the correct output. So this is the input directory. Here we have one input file. Let's see what this contains. So it contains four words: hello, how are you? Now let's try to run this jar file just to demonstrate if it is working fine and generating the correct output. So we can execute this jar file like Hadoop jar, the jar file name, then the main class inside this. If you don't know the name, you can go to build directory and check the path for the main class. Then we will provide the input and output directories. This is our input directory, and this is the output directory where we want our output. Let's try to execute it. So the jar is executed. Let's see if our output is generated. You can see an output directory is created. And we have a success and a part file. Let's see the output. Cat. So we have our correct output. Hello, how are you? Every word is occurring one time. Now let's take the same jar file and schedule it with the help of Oozie. First I'll remove this output directory because we are going to run this again. I have also placed the same build under HDFS, WC test word count 3 path. Now let's see the scheduler UI. You can go to U, under U you can go to Query, Scheduler, then Workflow. Here you will see different kind of jobs that you can schedule. If you want, you can edit the name here, My Workflow. I'll leave it as it is. Let's come to the point. So we have a Java program. This is the Java program. If you have Spark job or Hive job or Pig script, you can pick whatever type of code you have. I have a Java program. I'll pull this and drag to this area. Now it is asking jar name. So if you see, it is asking path to the jar on HDFS. I have already placed it under HDFS. We can browse our HDFS directly from here. If you see WC test word count 3, under this I have wordcount.jar. Now the main class. Our main class inside that build is org.myorg.wordcount. So let's add this. Now if you remember, our jar file was expecting two arguments also. So let's provide the arguments. First argument was the input path. And the second argument was the output path. And then you can click here to save it. You can see the page is saved. Now there are two things you can do here. Either you can submit the job. In this case, this workflow will start executing and you will get the output whatever code you have provided here. Second option is you can schedule this workflow with help of a coordinator and then this job will run at whatever start or end time or whatever intervals you have provided. So I'll show you both ways. First I'll submit this. This job will execute from Oozie and we will see if we are getting the output. After that I'll show you how you can give the timelines or start or end time or the frequency of jobs when you want this code to be executed. So let's try to submit this. If you see, as we submitted, it started executing. Let's wait for this. If you want, you can check the logs here. Tasks are running. XML, as I already told you, this is the workflow.xml that is automatically generated. Otherwise, we would have to generate this manually. This is automatically generated when we have submitted the job in the UI. We can go to our jobs. If you can see, it has just completed. 457, 458, just 1 minute back, it is completed. Now let's go and see if it has generated the output. Again, you can see the output is generated and we are getting the expected output. Now let's remove this directory again. Now let's see how we can schedule the same to any start or end time or to any frequency that we need. Here you can see all your workflows. This is my workflow, as we didn't edit the name. This is the one. For scheduling the same, now we can go to Query, Scheduler and Schedule. Here you can configure your coordinator. Let's rename it. If you want, you can rename this. Now it will ask which workflow you want to schedule. You can choose a workflow. We had my workflow. Now what will be the frequency for your schedule? You will get the options for hour, day, week, month, year, everything. So for this demonstration, it will consider my VM time. So it's 5:54. Let me try to schedule it at 5:56. So I want it every hour at 56th minute. So it will come to this hour also. Also, if you wanted to execute on multiple minutes in an hour, you can make multiple selections also. But I don't need it. I'll just schedule it at 56th minute. In this options, you will also get option to select time zone and start and end date. By default, it will take 7 days, 18th to 25th. If you want, you can change it. Now it is scheduled at 56th. It's already 55. Let me change it to 57. And that's all. I'm not changing the time zone because the same time zone is there in my Cloudera VM. So I'm leaving it as it is and saving it. Once you save it, you can go to this button and submit. Now once this is saved, you can see the current schedule is in waiting status. It is waiting for 5:57 because we scheduled it at 57th minute. And here you can see next run is at 6:57. Whatever schedule by day or hour you have scheduled, it will show you the next run and the current status. So let's wait for 1 minute. It's already 5:56. I'll forward the video. Once this reaches 5:57, you can see the status here will automatically change. You can see here at 5:57, it has come in running state. Let's wait for the execution. If you want, you can check the logs meanwhile for the running jobs. And you can see at 5:57, within 1 minute only, it has succeeded. Now let's see the jobs. In jobs, you can see the word count program. At 5:57, it took 27.90 seconds and it is succeeded. Now let's see if our output is generated. You can see our output directory is generated. Also our count is generated. So this is how you can schedule a workflow in Oozie and define your times and frequencies with the help of the coordinator. If you come to schedules, you can see different schedulers. Like this was the coordinator we just created. If you want any time, you can kill it so that it won't execute the next run. So guys, now let's try to do the same with the help of shell scripting. I'll remove the directory first. Output directory is removed. So here, as you know, if we execute this command, Hadoop jar, jar file name, the main class name, and the arguments. If we execute it, whatever interaction we do on this terminal, this interaction is done to the Linux shell. So shell scripting is nothing but we mention all the instructions that we interact on the command line and write all of them into a file, and we can save that. And when we execute that file, all of the commands inside that file that were supposed to be run one by one in command line, that will get executed once that single file is executed. We call that single file as shell script. Let me show you how you can create a shell script and schedule it in your Linux VM. As of now, you can see this is the command that we are interacting with the command line. So what I will do, let's create a shell script in this folder. Create document, empty file, scheduler.sh. By default, the shell script extension is .sh. You can open it. And you can mention whatever command you want to execute on the shell and just save it. If you also want some more commands like some create directory or remove directory, whatever you want, you can mention in the same, in the next line or the previous line. So let's close this. Let me open this in terminal. So here you can see this is our shell script. Make sure you have execute permission on this file. For execute permission, you can give sudo chmod. For changing the permission, you can give 755 for this scheduler. This is the shell script and it is ready to be executed. How we execute this is, if you are in the current path, you can do .slash and scheduler.sh. If I run this, whatever commands are there in the scheduler.sh will get executed. But we do not want to do that. We want to schedule this. So for scheduling, we need crontab. Crontab is a utility in Linux with which you can schedule the CLI commands giving the star values. I'll simply show you with help of a website. This is crontab guru. You can find this crontab pattern in many of the other websites also. So this crontab pattern consists of all the values depicts different values like minute, hour, day, month, etc. So suppose we'll try to create the same thing. In my VM, current time is 6:06. I'll try to schedule it at 6:10. So it will be every 10th minute. You can see here it also shows at minute 10. So this will be the pattern. There can be many other patterns depending upon your requirement. I'll quickly show you how you can schedule this pattern with the shell script. You have to go to sudo crontab. This crontab is user based. That's why I'm using sudo, so that I can schedule it as the admin. So crontab hyphen e stands for edit. We have to edit the crontab. You can first mention the pattern, that is this, followed by a space, and after space you have to give complete path till that script. That is this followed by the script name, which is scheduler.sh. Now you can go ahead and save this. You can see the message installing new crontab. If you just want to view the crontab, you can go for crontab hyphen l. It will show you that this script is scheduled at 10th minute of every hour. So now let's see, our time is 6:08. So supposedly it should run after 2 minutes. Sorry guys, I forgot to mention the path, because if we schedule this, it won't find the word count.jar in the current directory, right? So first I'll mention the cd command wherever my jar file is there. Then when it comes to that directory, it will find the word count.jar. I'll save it and I'll reschedule my crontab. Again, for rescheduling, crontab hyphen e. And it's 6:13. I'll schedule it at insert 6:14. Now let's wait for 1 more minute. So within 1 minute, you can see the output directory is generated and we have our word count output. Let's check that for the last time. And we are having correct output. Also, if you want to disable and not delete the crontab, you can go to edit mode and put a hash behind this. This will comment it out and then you can save it back. So guys, that was all. I hope you liked this video. In this video, I told you how to schedule big data jobs with the help of Oozie as well as shell scripting. So I hope you liked this video. If you did, please hit that like button and please subscribe to my channel if you have not already done. I'll try to bring more tutorials on Oozie in my coming sessions. Thank you guys, take care.